Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you a 1965 Jefferson nickel out of an SMS set. SMS stands for Special Mint Set. 1965, they didn't have a regular mint set. The director said that they had to come out with something, so they put some coins together and called it a special mint set. I'm trying out a new camera. It seems like it jumps a little bit from what I've seen so far. I guess that probably makes some of you pretty dizzy probably. But I'm working with what I got. I bought a new camera and it didn't work out at all. So now I'm trying another one. So you guys tell me what you think about the new camera and about the coin. It's a beautiful proof light coin. It's got a slightly rotated reverse. See, straight up and down. Slightly rotated. See how close this thing will focus. Close enough to where it won't show. That's pretty nice. I do have some new lighting on the way also. It's one of those light rings that showers a nice LED light down on the subject. So I'm going to be trying that out as well. But I wanted to try this camera. And let me know what you guys think. Does the focusing bother you? It really doesn't bother me all that much because it focuses. It's not in and out real slow. It just, bam, focuses. I kind of like that. Just like that. He does have some spots on his cheek. I just now seen that right there. You can see those there. It looks like feeder finger damage. Feeder finger damage on his cheek, I think. Usually when they're uniform dots like that, that's what they are, is feeder finger damage. But I've run my mouth enough. Just wanted to bring this to you guys and let you check it out and test out this camera. Let me know what you think in the comments. Or if you know of any budget-friendly cameras that focus up close. And I'm talking with my hands, and I don't know why, because you guys can't see my hand. Here, maybe I'll put it out here like this so you can see my hand. If you know of any, if you know of any cameras that focus up close and don't jerk and jitter, or constantly focus in and out real slow, like the one that I just bought did. The one I bought is great for vlogging. I mean, it's great for vlogging, but it's not good for up close. Because it's constantly like this. And then it'll focus. And then it'll come back in. And then it'll go back out like that. And it'll focus. It's weird. And my normal camera, which is a cell phone camera, and so is this one, the one I'm on now. I'm actually on Lala's phone, my wife. She said, here, use mine, see what mine does. So hers is a newer phone than mine, so maybe it'll be a little bit better. I notice it's not jerking whenever I'm still. So when I move, it'll snap into focus, then maybe it'll stay there if I stay there. Now, I could deal with that, and I think you guys could too, but as soon as I go to move it, it refocuses. That's pretty good, actually, though. Now, if I had better lighting, we're about 3 inches away from the camera right there. How close can we get and still see? Can't really, well, Monticello's kind of fuzzy right there. You see it right there? I'm about 2.5-3 inches away from the lens. It's not too bad. Let me know if you guys know of any. Email me, tinynumismatics@gmail.com. Same as my name here on YouTube. The new camera I got is the Sony W800. It's a point and shoot camera, and it's really good for vlogging, but it's not very good for up close. It's really good for photos too. It's a 20 megapixel camera, but I just don't think the mechanism inside is as good as what it's cracked up to be. But I love each and every one of you, and we hope this finds you guys safe and healthy. And like I said before, I've ran my mouth enough. So you guys don't forget to check that pocket change, because you never know what you got in your pocket until you look. And I don't know how to get it to stop.